A sharp increase in militant attack in Mozambique's northern province of Cabo Delgado has forced the government to reassess its strategy against the Islamic insurgents. What's behind the conflict? The region has long experienced instability, but the insurgency involving Islamic militants began in 2017. Local Al-Shabaab militia operating in the area are believed to have links to the wider Islamic State group IS. High-level poverty and disputes over access to land and job have contributed to local grievances. But Cabo Delgado's importance to the government and a further reason for local frustrations lies in the rich offshore natural gas collaboration with multinational energy companies. The militants have had considerable success gaining recruits both from within the province and further afield. Attacks by militant groups have increased significantly over the past years. There have been more than 570 violent incidents from January to December 2020 in the province. Human rights groups have reported the extensive destruction throughout. These have included killings, beheading, and kidnappings, with deaths from attacks carried out by all groups involved in the conflict, rising sharply in 2020. Horrifying incident was of 50 people beheaded in a sports field over the course of March 2021. The instability has led to a huge number of people leaving their homes in areas where conflict has erupted. Nearly 670,000 people were internally displaced in Cabo Delgado, Niassa, and Nampula provinces by the end of 2020, according to the UN Office for the Coordination of Humanitarian Affairs. What is the role of the US forces? To support the efforts in tackling the growing insurgency, the Mozambican government have invited the U.S. military advisors. The agreement between Mozambican and U.S. government is for American soldiers to train local forces fighting the militants. U.S. Special Operations Forces will support Mozambique's effort to prevent the spread of terrorism and violent extremism, the U.S. Embassy in Mozambique said on 15 March 2021. But analysts believe the U.S. is framing the insurgency in a very oversimplified manner by referring to the militants as an extension of the Islamic State. On March 10, the U.S. government designated Al-Shabaab in Mozambique as a foreign terrorist organization, describing it as an Islamic State affiliate. Portugal, the former colonial power of Mozambique, has also committed to train the military of Mozambique and has sent 60 trainers to train Mozambique Special Forces and Commandos, mercenary forces. Although the Mozambique government has is reticent about acknowledging their presence, private military contractors have been operating in the region alongside its security forces. Initially in 2019, Russian mercenaries from the Wagner Group were involved in the region. More recently, the South African-based DIC Advisory Group, DAG, was believed to have been invited by the government to help it fight insurgents. A recent Amnesty International report on human rights abuses committed in Cabo Delgado implicated this group as well as government forces and the militants in the unlawful killings of civilians. But there are also concerns about the effectiveness of these private contractors. And despite the fact that the private contractors, the fight in Mozambique is getting heated. While the Russian Wagner forces have, tried as much as possible to release some possible impact, but the Mozambique government is working with the Russian mercenaries, working with South African DAG, working with the US Special Forces special units, and also working with Portugal and so many other international governments trying to help in fight against terrorism and Al-Shabaab militants.